Asante sana. We may be seated. My friend, the Deputy Governor of Embu County, the Honorable Justice Kenyu Amugo, CC Jamal, all the senior officers, our partners from the consortium that is assisting us with fixing our healthcare. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am very, very, very happy to be here today. And as the DG has said, for me, Embu is a second home. And we say charity begins at home. So I decided that everything that I try to do in government, I always try from here in Embu. So I hope when I come with a dangerous poison, God forbid, it shall not be Embu first. But it's because I find very good environment to do the right thing in Embu County. Embu County, and I'm not saying they are bad counties, is the only county which I know. If something is not working in Embu, then it will not work. It's not because somebody amweka sumu hapa pale. Yeah? I don't take it for granted, Bonadiji, that when we came here with the industrial park, it is you. The president announced here about our industrial park, which now became part of the whole country. And I am sure where we have got this kind of environment to do the right thing, I'm sure it will succeed. We've been here. Today is the third day of our engagement with the Embu County. And what I know is that it has been 3 days, very successful days. We came here on Monday, on a Wednesday. We learned some lessons. We did a very successful public sensitization at Rokorire. Yesterday, our team was there in Mungania, and even leo tunaenda Kadangariri kuongea na watu wetu kwa sababu we are tackling this from all angles. We also had an opportunity to meet on Wednesday with the leadership of our CHPs, our ground army. Yeah? CHPs is our army. Jeshi ya nchikavu katika hii vita. And today we are now here today to talk to you, people from our facilities, people from our providers, because you are really, if the CHPs are our ground army, you are our frontline soldiers in this program. And for me, as I was telling DG, just having all of you together, hata sasa naweza kuchukua mgumi niende nyumbani. I've already succeeded because this is really the beginning point of success. When all of us, we are here maybe probably around 150 of us, yeah, from all sub-counties, from all the facilities in Embu County. So kama kuna mtu ataangusha healthcare for 600,000 people, ni wa hao watu wako hapa. Na Biblia inasema, yule mtu ambaye atapoteza watu wa Mungu, atawekelewa jiwe kwa shingo, halafu atupwe kwa bahari. So hii mambo ya taifa kia ikifil Embu, I just need to kuwekelea nyinyi nyote mko hapa nini jiwe kwa shingo, na niwatupe pale Rupingazi na dunia iendelee. Because you really are the solution. Ama namna gani? And you are the problem. You are the problem and you are the solution. So, hakuna mtu mwingine. It is you guys. Yeah? So, when mwananchi is complaining, oh, SHA is not working. Oh, this is not working. This is not working. Oh, Ruto hii SHA yako. Sasa, leo niko na mchoro. These are the real problems. Ziko hapa. Never before has so many problems been collected in one room. Hata tunaweza kuchoma kibiriti alafu tuende. Because we really are the people who can make a difference. And you know, we are not here to talk about agriculture. We are not here to talk about education. Agriculture, mtu anaweza kulala njaa leo, ama kesho Mungu amsaidie. Education ni vizuri kuwa educated because that's why you are here. Lakini hata wale hawakuwa educated hawakukufa. Lakini healthcare hakuna chance nyingine. We don't have two chances in life. And so we cannot be here about a job. We hear about lives. And you know, we have doctors here, we have clinic officers here, we have nurses here, we have lab techs here, yeah, we have pharmacists here. Everybody is here. Everybody here who can make or break people's life is here. And you know your odds. Mulajua, the odds you've taken even more than me. So you are the people who are very much more aware and much more conversant with the calling that you made, not before man, but also before God. Yeah? Because that is that's really the all that you took, that you will protect lives and you not one life will be lost for something you could have done. So as you save the life of patient, you also have to save the life of Shah, the life of Taifa Care. And that's why we ask you today, wacha mgonjwa kwanza akae huko, na wale ambao umeacha, at least for us, we come here and see how we can be able to work together to make this work. I am very, very encouraged by your registration numbers. I think Embu is now number 2-3 in terms of percentage, and this is how we are calculating it. Embu population, as per our census, 680,000. Wale wako registered, karibu 130 now munaelekea hapo. So mko wale 21%. And CHPs, we have a story, we have agreed with them that gap would be covered by people who are not adding beneficiaries. We have got children who are going back to school in January. So we want my target for Embu County. By the time we are finishing the first week of school in January, we should hit 95%. So when we say 95%, it will be Embu will be the benchmark for the rest of the country. That's why we are attacking it from all angles. Kwa mwananchi, mimi, governor, deputy governor, viongozi wenu, we are doing our job. I told you we are in Rukulire, we are going to Kadagalire today, we are in Mungani yesterday, and we will continue doing it. Yeah? So we are doing that. Two, these CHPs are... We are sending them now to go to the homes, not wait for the people to come to the facilities so that we make their work easier. Three, you people now in the facilities, because you've been missing from this chain link. Yeah? If we deploy our 63 level two facilities, our 36 level 3 facilities, our 13 level 4s, and our PGH, if each of those points also become a touch point for solving this problem will disappear. February tutakuwa tunaongea mambo mengine hapa Embu. Yeah, tutakuwa tunaongea mambo ya vitu zingine, si mambo ya UHC. If today, in my estimation, in terms of, and we have our experts here from Safaricom, from Apeiro, from Convergence, people who have been rolling out this, so they'll be able to take us through, what you should expect. But in my estimation, we have just, whatever people are calling rollout is only systems at the top. But this is not the way we designed this universal healthcare. Yeah, I'm speaking with the privilege of somebody who was with this right from the point we are writing our manifesto. So I understand it like the back of my hand. And I'm very, very certain, and I'm very sure. And you go and write somewhere, and you go and engrave it in stone, Taifa Care will be the best health system in the whole world. I have no doubt about that. Yeah, and I'm not just a villager. Nimetembea hapa na pale duniani. So I know what I am talking about, that this program will be one of the best, an award-winning. Where to party? I can be the one that comes to Tahiti, Tahiti, to the UN, Amakwa Nobel, the best, the most comprehensive health management system in the world. And why? Because you are here in front of me, 101 facilities. Remember, we have got another 100 in the private sector. Not our own, the private sector. Unajua sasa, nyinyi mko na mashindano. Mko na mashindano katikati yenu na hao. Why? Because for the first time in the continent of Africa, we have got you know, same treatment. Whether you're in private sector, whether in public sector, is the same. So customer, mgonjo atakuwa naangalia hospitali yako. Akiona mende, akiona uchafu, anaingia wapi? Private. Asema si kadi ni ile. Si benefit ni zile. So it is non-discriminative. So it's all over. So the pressure would be on you. Because not only does this health system not discriminate between big people, rich people, powerful people, mama boga, president of Kenya, same treatment. Private hospital, public hospital, same treatment. Yeah? Daktari wa hapa, daktari ya Kakamega, daktari ya Kogaliza, same treatment. I take my test here in Embu. Niko na safari ya kwenda Turukana, naingia Turukana, nakuta prescription na nagojea Turukana. It follows me. You know, the minute this thing would sink into people, it's when they will know that we here, we are dealing with a gem, we are dealing with a wonderful thing. And it, I think for me, it is imperative to say it must work. Now, let me not preempt what the experts will tell you in terms of the systems, in terms of what to expect. But let me just say, talk about for you guys, our health professionals. You are very much aware that we are solely depending on the data, your data, as provided for by KMPDC. And it is very important that you keep on checking on your. Sasa mimi namwambia mwananchi aangalie status yake kwa afya yangu. Na wewe, haujaangalia status yako as a professional. It should start with you. So that we know, because that's your record, my friend. And, you know, things don't go bad. Things start bad. So, tusipochunga hapa, mwanzo, then, you know, you will start complaining. Wewe goja mbaka, mtu atumie namba yako ya KMPDC kupeana the wrong prescription. Na najua tumesema, we are activating our SMS. SMS alerts. So that if your number is used for any claim, yeah, and you know what that means, because we are activating it to be sent on your phone. What that means is that you are personally responsible. That's what that means, is that you have a footprint in the system. Yeah? So it's very important that, you know, now as we finish with Mwananchi, as we do the decision of Mwananchi, nyinyi pia, you get conversant, and I think the team, our technical partners, will be able to tell you what to expect. So that's number one. Two is on the devices. I know we rolled out 86 devices. I think every facility here, level 2, level 3, they have got at least one device. Our intention for level 3, and they will tell you, is that for level 2, first of all, we will start operating with the device that you have, the way the system was designed to work. So we'll be told how we are going to upload our hospital information management system on the one device that you have. Is it enough? No. Is it a good start? Yes. Because at least using that one, you'll be able to register your patient. You'll be able to do all your clinical processes. You'll be able to make your e-claim. You'll be able to do all those things that our people will be able to tell you. For level 3, Bwana Jamal, is that we agreed, we are suggesting that every level 3 has at least a device, which is very good. But now the donations we got from our friends from USAID, at least tuongeze hospitali 10 peke yake kwanza. Yeah, so that hospitali 10 will have at least 5 plus 1, 5 the ones from USAID, and the one we had rolled out in the beginning of the project. So 10 level 3 hospitals. By this Christmas, we'll be operating super duper the way it's supposed to work. Yani katika hizo hospitali 10, na hizo katika all our level 3s, level 2s, tumemaliza taifa care. We are not leaving Embu with anything hanging. Kama kuna swali ya mwananchi, hapo. Kama kuna swali ya daktari, hapo. Kama kuna swali ya facility, hapo. Because what we are here to do and what we are declaring today, what we came to launch today, is we want to create Embu as a taifa care center of excellence. Yeah? Such that January, kabla niende Vihiga, my next stop is Vihiga. Before I go to Vihiga, Vihiga would have come here to Embu, come vile tunenda ASK showground pale. Yeah, kuangalia how this health thing is supposed to work. Yeah? Sasa kwetu tunasema moto kwako ikiwaka, si unamwambia mumpatie mwingine. So mimi nataka watu wa Vihiga wakuje waazime moto hapa. Nao watu wa hapo Nandi jirani yao waende Vihiga waazime hiyo moto. Tuende nikienda Mombasa watu wa hiyo. So you people, you must know, you must feel the weight of the responsibility of what we are doing here in Embu. We are not just doing the normal activity. We are here for the whole country. We are here to ensure that things work. And let me say, every other problem that I'm discovering here in Embu, we are taking remedial action immediately. Hakuna mtu mizi zumbui nikitoka hapa hapa na DG. Mpaka raisi halali, anajua hivyo. Na hawa wote watakuambia watu wa, because of the, when I'm here, we are able to get the real feedback. We got feedback from Mwananchi, Juzi, tumeenda tume improve our system. I am sure today you give us feedback. We will go and improve our system. Our CHPs, Juzi tulikuwa hapa, nikarealize, bado wanaripia bundles, hata wakisaidia Mwananchi. Sasa simuko sawa. Si nimewafungulia sasa bundles ni free. Na sio hawa peke yake. We have rolled it out now for the whole country. So Ebu is a Noah's Ark. Ile Sabina nani ya Nuhu. Ile itaokoleka hapa, itaokoa dunia mzima. So because of the seed of Embu that we have planted here in Embu, we are able now, yeah, all our 90,000 CHPs. And I'm still looking for the other 18,000 to make it 108,000. Now as we speak, they have got free bundles. Na nimeambia PS, because mimi mwenye ameniambia mambo ya pesa, nikamwambia mimi kwa idhini ya rais wa Kenya ndio nitampatia pesa. So I want to promise you by end of next week, arrears are CHPs. Hakuna CHP atakuwa na arrears. Vile tumefanya kwa bundles, ndio tutafanya kwa CHP. And again, it's not for Embu. It's for the whole country. Because the Noah's Ark is in Embu. So what we are doing here is what we replicate for the whole country. Sasa nyinyi CHP moyo wakolea wa Kenya wote, our wonderful CHPs all over the country, now they are whitelisted by our providers. They are getting free bundles to go and help Mwananchi, especially as we move to go to the door to door. Sasa mambo ya arrears, your stipend, we will solve it not just for Embu but for the whole country, and all the other things that we'll be able to get from here, we are solving it for the whole country. So let me wish you the best as we listen to our experts. And one thing I want to say, tafadhali, na pengine wengi wenu mnanijua, yeah, mimi sina white ball ya kuficha. Tunaelewana? Leo museme yenu yote ama mnyamaze forever, si ndio? Na hakuna mkubwa na hakuna mdogo, na hakuna chief officer, na hakuna CEC, na hakuna DG, na hakuna advisor, na hakuna nani, hakuna engineer, na hakuna technician, na hakuna mechanic. Tuko sawa wote leo. Because if you go back to your facilities with problems, sasa mtasaidika na mna gani? So mimi nimesema yangu na sitaficha. Pahali mnakosea nitawaambia. So kwa nini mnifiche na nimetoka all the way to present to you? Thank you very much, Bwana Jamal. Now we can proceed with the rest of the program. Asante sana.